Hey, what's going on, guys? Today we are inside of Affinity Designer, and I want to show you how I created this water text effect that we can see in front of us. So if we have a look at this image, we can see that I've created just a few different lines that go throughout the text, which kind of gives it that wave effect. And inside of these, I've just blended that in with the background behind it. So if we have a look inside of the letters, we've got this kind of 3D cutout effect with these drop shadows, which give it a little bit of depth as well as a darker image in the background, almost as though you're looking at the bottom of the ocean. So if this is something you would like to learn, then let's get started. The first thing that we want to do is create a brand new canvas. I've already got one open over here on the right hand side, just with our background image that we are going to use. If you guys want to use the same image, I will put a download link in the description, or alternatively, you are free to use any image that you like. So for now, I'm going to come over to the layer section on the right hand side. I'm just going to toggle that visibility so we can't see it, just so we can work on the white background for now. And we'll come back to that image a little bit later when we come to need it. So what we want to do first of all is go over to our tools on the left hand side, and we're going to grab our rectangle tool. And I'm just going to draw a rectangle that's going to cover the entire canvas. So just like that, and give that a fill of any color that you like. I'm just going to go for maybe a blue, and I'm just going to go and turn that stroke off as I don't need it. Then next, we just need to type out any kind of text that we want to use inside of our project. So if we go over to the left hand side and choose the artistic text tool, just drag that out to be as big as you like and type in anything that you would like to use. For me, I'm going to keep this the same as I've already showed you. So I'm going to write in water. Then I'm going to hit Command or Control A just to select all of that text so I can change the font. So I'm going to head up to the top left hand corner and change this from Arial to Impact, as Impact is one of my favorite fonts. Then I'm going to grab that move tool and just make this text a little bit bigger by dragging it out of the corner. Then I'm going to go up to the top menu bar to the alignment options. I'm going to center this horizontally as well as vertically. Go ahead and hit apply. And now that is in the center of the canvas. And what we need to do now is just right click inside of our text, and we're going to go down and we're going to convert this to curves. So once we convert to curves, that's going to make all of these letters its own individual shape. As you'll see, if we go over to the right hand side and open up this group, we now have an individual shape for each one of these letters, or is also known as a curve. So what I want to do is select all of these curves, and I want to take them outside of the group as I don't need the group. So if you select the top one right there, hold down shift and select the one at the bottom, that will select everything in between that. Then we can just drag these outside of the group, and then we'll go ahead and delete the group. Then what we need to do is subtract this text away from this background. So we want to cut it out, and we're going to do the same as we just did. We're going to select this R at the top, hold down shift and come down to the rectangle and select that. Then that will select everything else in between. Once you've got all of this selected, we're going to come up to the top menu bar and we're going to select this option right here, which is called subtract. Then once we've done that, it's now cut out the letters from this rectangle. And we can confirm that this has worked if we go back over to our layers on the right hand side, and we just turn on this background image of water once again. So once we turn this on, we'll be able to see it through these letters, as you can see. But just for the moment, I'm going to go ahead and turn that back off while we continue with the tutorial. So what we want to do next is now just start creating our wavy lines that go through the text or any other kind of shape that you would like to use yourself. And to do that, I'm just going to deselect any of these layers I've got here just by clicking anywhere inside of this dark background. And now I've not selected any of those. Then I'm going to go over to the left hand side and I'm going to choose the pencil tool. Then it is just a case of us drawing our wavy lines throughout the text. So before we do that, I just want to go over to the right hand side and take you down to this stroke section. If you guys can't see this stroke section on your version of Affinity, then just go up to the top menu bar, choose view. Go down to where it says studio and just make sure that you have your stroke section checked, and you'll have access to that menu also. So inside of this stroke section, what we want to do is focus on our pressure settings. So once you select that, you're going to see we've got this curve inside of here. You guys are probably going to have this reset just as standard like that. And if you want to create the same curve that I'm going to do, we're just going to tap anywhere in the center of here to create a new box. Then we're just going to drag this corner side down to roughly around here. And what this is going to allow us to do is have a thinner end at the edges. And as it gets towards the middle, it's going to get thicker, back down to getting thinner again. And you'll see that as I draw it. Then we'll just start drawing our lines. But what I need to do first of all is turn a color stroke on, as at the moment it's clear, so we're not going to see it as we start drawing. So I'll go ahead and just color that black for the moment. Then we'll just head back over to the left-hand side and just start drawing in our wavy lines just from one side to the other with an up and down motion. And we just got to keep doing that again and again underneath each other. You can have as many of these as you like. Just kind of follow that same pattern that you got above for that wave effect. And like I said before, you can use any kind of shapes that you like inside of here. It doesn't have to be waves. It's entirely up to you. And just add as many as you like. I think I'm going to do just maybe one more. Just drag that all the way to the end. And if you find that your strokes are too thick or they're not thick enough, if we come up to the top menu bar where it says width, we can change that from being 30 points to something smaller or something bigger. It's entirely up to you what you want to do with that. I'm going to keep that at 30. And what we could also do, if you didn't quite get the curve that you wanted, if we go and grab our node tool on the left-hand side, we can now grab all of these individual points and we can move those around just to try and fine-tune that to go for what it is you're trying to achieve. But just to be quick, I'm going to leave that the way it was. So I'm just going to grab my move tool for a moment. So now that I have my strokes going through my text, what we need to do now is convert these strokes into being curves. As if we don't do this, it's not going to work. So the way we're going to do that is come back over to our layers on the right hand side. We're going to select our top curve. We're going to hold down shift and then select the one at the bottom. That then will select everything in between that. Then we're going to go over to the left hand side top menu bar. We're going to choose layer and we're going to go down to where it says expand stroke. So once we select expand stroke, that essentially is now going to convert these strokes into their own shape or curve. And like I said, this is a really important step. If you don't do this, it's not going to work with this kind of effect. So now with all of these still selected, we also need to select this layer underneath it, which is going to be our water layer. So if we just hold down command and select that one also, that's going to be able to enable us to grab all of these at the same time. Then we're going to come back up to our menu that we used previously. And this time, instead of hitting subtract, we're going to go to the left hand side and we're going to hit add. And what this has done is combined these wave effects that we just got inside of here with the background. So it all now is just one shape. And from here is now where we turn on this background layer that we used earlier and we can go ahead and use this. So if we just turn this back on now, what we need to do is remove this from being in the background and inserting it inside of this water layer. And to do that, we're just going to simply select the image layer underneath it. And we're just going to drag this up and over to the right slightly till we get this smaller blue bar up here, just like that right there. Then let it go. And now you can see that it's filled our entire rectangle, as well as all those wave lines that we created. So what we need to do next is now select the curve layer above it and not the image. So once we selected that, we want to come down to where we have our effects menu. And we're going to go ahead and put an outer shadow on this. And you can change these numbers to be anything that you like, but I'm going to try maybe 15 on the radius and 15 on the offset. And that doesn't look too bad. I'm going to bring the opacity up a little bit so it's a bit of a darker shadow. So if we just come off this for a minute, you can now see that it kind of looks as though it's being cut out and we've got that 3D depth effect inside. So you can already see how this is kind of coming together. This looks pretty good the way it is, but we're going to take it a little bit further and just put an image inside that and just a few more different effects. So what we want to do next is we're going to copy this image that we've got in the background to put inside of the text. So if we go back over to our layers on the right hand side, we select the image that we've already got and we hit Command or Control C to copy, then Command or Control V to paste. That will then give us another copy of our background. But what we need to do is drag this out of the curve. So I'm just going to pull this up and out. And at the moment, this is sat on top of this layer so we can no longer see it. So I'm going to drag that back down underneath it. And now you can see that image is in the background of that text. So the first thing we want to do is just zoom out a little bit so I can move this around. I'm just going to hold down Command or Control as I drag from one of these corners just to bring it in on itself a little bit. I want to make it a little bit smaller on the inside just to kind of add to that depth effect. I'm just going to zoom back in with Command 0 to fit to screen, or Control 0 if you're on a PC. Then next, we just want to make this image a little bit darker in the background. So if we come down to our effects menu just down here where we have adjustments, select that one. We're going to go for brightness and contrast. And we're just going to bring this brightness down a little bit just to make that a little bit darker inside, almost like you are looking at the bottom of the ocean. So somewhere around there looks pretty good. So I'm just going to go ahead and come out of that. And of course, if you want a bigger shadow, you can always come back into the effects just to kind of make it look deeper and just change these numbers on the radius and the offset to either be bigger or smaller. It's entirely up to you and what it is that you want to go for. I'm going to maybe put that on 20 on both. And of course, just play with the opacity to make that a bit darker or lighter, whatever it is that you want to go for, as well as maybe change your angle down here if you want the shadow coming from a different direction. So at the moment, just as it is, that looks pretty good in my opinion. And like I say, you can use any kind of image that you like and different words inside of here and different shapes. But I just want to make this just a little bit more creative. And what I'm going to do is select back on this curve menu once again. And I'm going to add a stroke around this text as well, just to see what that looks like. So I'm going to come up here. I'm going to choose a color white. And that is definitely far too big. So first thing we need to do is come down here and reset our pressure, as that's going to mess around with our stroke. And then we're going to simply change the width here to be something a lot smaller, and that looks better. So maybe around 2 points is pretty good, or maybe go for 3. And we'll just go ahead and have a look, see what that looks like. That doesn't look too bad at all. And also, if you wanted to, you could go in and add a second stroke around this just for a bit more of an effect. And the way we do that is by coming up to the top right hand corner, going over to where it says appearance. And we're going to come down here to where it says add stroke. But before that's going to highlight, we need to make sure that we are on the layer that we want to add the stroke to. So we go ahead and select that water layer once again. Go and hit that add stroke. That's going to give us a second stroke. Then it's just a case of coming up here and choosing the color that we want. So I'm going to go for maybe a darker blue. Then we just need to change the size of the stroke. And the way that we would do that is by tapping on this 1 point section right there. Then we can go ahead and change the size of this. So I'm going to make that roughly around 3. And what we need to do at this point, because we can't actually see both strokes, is come down to where we've got the alignment options. And we want to choose this one in the middle, which is going to be on the inside. So once we select that, you can now see that we can see the blue stroke as well as a white stroke. And you can simply add as many different strokes as you like. You can have 5 or 6 in there if you want. It's entirely up to you. But if we have a little look at what we've got so far, I think that looks pretty good. If anything, I'll maybe make that background a little bit darker. And if for any reason you don't like the strokes at all, just come back into our appearance menu after selecting our layer. And we can go ahead and just turn those off. And we're back to where we started. In my opinion, I kind of like it this way. But the option is there if you want to add additional strokes yourself. So that is it for today's video. If you did like this effect, then please hit that like button, comment and subscribe, as it really helps me out with the YouTube algorithm and helps other people find my content. And if any of you guys are brand new to Affinity Designer, then I do have a crash course available which will teach you all the basics and everything that you need to know to get you started on your very first project. I will link that in the top right hand corner now. I also have crash courses available for Affinity Photo as well as Affinity Publisher. So go ahead and check those out also if you want to learn those. But for now, I hope you have a great day and I will see you in my next video.